Mike Dyson worked 90 to 100 hours each week as a manager for an auto parts company.
I worked all those hours, in essence, almost like a slave. I mean, it's really what I was. If you start computing what you're making per hour, it was next to nothing. I'd get as many as 300 to 500 emails a day. I mean, you know, you're like a sinking ship. You know, you just can't ever really catch up.
Mike knew stress and the long hours were taking their toll on his health and his relationship with his wife, Becky.
Going to the movies or date nights and things like that were pretty well probably non-existent for the most part. You know, it was just kind of work, work, work.
Mike decided to quit his job and look for a new one. He took one with less stress, but also less money.
My wife and I were watching the 700 Club. It was really my wife that brought up, said, you know, we should sow into that ministry. And at the time, you know, like I said, we were living paycheck to paycheck. We called in and made that $20 a month pledge and commitment.
That same year, God told them to buy into a fitness center franchise.
We really sought God. We did some fasting and got quiet and really tried to seek what God wanted us to do. We felt this was the thing for us.
The business took off and exceeded all expectations in its first 6 months.
Are we blessed? We are. But we wholeheartedly believe and know that it's about pouring the blessings through us to other people and to other ministries, you know, like CBN and 700 Club.
Today, Mike and Becky own two fitness franchises and are considering a third.
But when we started tithing to CBN, that atmosphere changed in our lives. And to see where we were and where we are now, it's only God could do that.
I've not worked in the corporate world, or I haven't worked for someone else now for over 2 years. It's just unbelievable where we're at today. God was teaching us something. We stepped into that law of reciprocity, and I think God was teaching, again, it goes back to the trust level, and that He is a trustworthy God. He's trustworthy.